Welcome to Understand the Math. Today I'm going to teach you the easiest way to simplify rational expressions. I'll show you four steps that you can always follow and then walk through three example problems so you'll know exactly how to do the simplification. Be sure to check out the link below for free guided notes that you can use while you watch this video. There's space in the notes for you to highlight the concepts and steps that we'll go over and fill out the answers to the examples that we're going to do. Notice the box on the right. It shows the color codes I've used to organize these notes. Before we go over the simplification steps, let's quickly review what a rational expression is. It's a fraction with polynomials in both the numerator and the denominator. The four steps that we can use to simplify a rational expression are listed here, and I'll go over these more in depth as we walk through our example problems. The first step that we need to follow is to factor the numerator and denominator. The second step is to list the restricted values. These are values where the denominator is equal to zero. The third step is to cancel the common factors. And then the fourth step is to write the final answer and state the restricted values if there are any. Let's now work through our examples. Our first example is not as complicated as the next two, so that we can make sure that we understand the steps. I've listed the steps on the right so that we can easily see what we need to do. Let's start with the first step and factor the numerator and denominator. When we look at the numerator, we can see that a 6x is common to both terms, so we can pull that out. That gives us 6x times what's left, and what's left is an x minus 2. There's only one term in the denominator, so we don't need to factor it. Let's now list the restricted values. The restricted values are going to be where the denominator, 3x, is equal to 0. So that gives us x is equal to 0, and we have to restrict that. So we'll write this as x is not equal to 0. The next step is to cancel the common factors. We see that there's an x common to both the numerator and denominator, so we can cross it out. And then we notice that 3 divides into 6 two times, so we'll cross out the 3 and make the 6 a 2. We can then write down the final answer. It's going to be 2 times the quantity x minus 2 with the restriction that x is not equal to 0. It's really important to put that restriction because you can see with our final answer, there is no denominator, so we wouldn't know from looking at 2 times x minus 2 that x is equal to 0 was restricted unless we wrote that down. Let's highlight our answer. To simplify our second example, we need to start by factoring both the numerator and the denominator. Since the constant term in both quadratics is 6 or minus 6, let's start by listing the factors of 6. These factors are plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, and then plus or minus 6. To factor the numerator, we need to find two numbers that add up to 5 and multiply to get 6. If we look at our choices from our list of factors, we can see that 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, and 2 times 3 is equal to 6. So our factors are going to be 2 and 3. Let's go ahead and write that down. We have an x plus 2 and an x plus 3. To factor the denominator, we need to find two numbers that add up to minus 1 and multiply to get minus 6. Looking again at our list of factors, these numbers are going to be minus 3 and 2 because they add up to minus 1 and they multiply to get 6. Let's highlight these. We can then put this factorization in the denominator, and this is going to be x minus 3 and x plus 2. To find our restricted values, we'll set x minus 3 equal to 0. And that's going to give us x is equal to 3. And then we'll set x plus 2 is equal to 0. And we'll get x is equal to minus 2. So let's add that our restricted values are x is not equal to minus 2 and it's not equal to 3. We'll now cancel our common factors and then we can write down our final answer. Our final answer is going to be x plus 3 divided by x minus 3 with the restriction that x can't equal minus 2 or 3. Hang with me for our third example. It's more challenging to factor because it has a difference of squares in the denominator, and you really need to see how to do one of these. To factor our numerator, we'll start by listing our factors of 4. Those are going to be plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, and plus or minus 4. To factor the numerator, we need to find two numbers that add up to minus 4 and multiply to get 4. These numbers are going to be minus 2 and minus 2. Let's go ahead and write down that factorization. We have x minus 2 times x minus 2. To factor the denominator, let's make a note that x squared minus a squared, the difference of two squares, is equal to x plus a times x minus a. And we can use that formula to get our factorization. This gives us an x plus 2 times an x minus 2 in the denominator. Let's make a note that x can't equal minus 2 or 2 because these numbers make the denominator equal to 0. Let's now cancel out the common factors. We have an x minus 2 in the numerator and an x minus 2 in the denominator. And that leaves us with a final answer of x minus 2 divided by x plus 2, with the restriction that x is not equal to minus 2 or 2. Just to quickly recap, when simplifying rational expressions, we factor the numerator and denominator, identify the restricted values, cancel the common factors, and then write the answer in simplified form. These steps will help you simplify any rational expression you might encounter. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.